I'm Dan.
I'm Hannah.
And we're London Grammar.
Yes.
And you're watching
Speaker TV.
I'm giving you a night call to tell you how I feel. I'm gonna drive you through the night.
London Grammar started really when me and Hannah first met at university. We were in halls, like halls of residence together. Then about sort of maybe a year and a half later, we met Dot, who's the third member who's not here. But and then we kind of just started playing together, and that was really like the how it became into existence, you know, as a trio, and it kind of just developed, the sound developed from there, and that was really how it began, I guess.
There's something inside you, boy, yeah. And you're still the same.
The way that London Grammar work is very collaborative. So we all kind of have become like a third of each other's brains in a way. There are some songs that, like a couple of songs I've written on the piano and brought to the table, and then Dan has, you know, added a guitar riff that is like his guitar playing is really, really rhythmic, so then that's really integral to then how the song will be produced, and Dot does a lot of production, and but we all kind of do everything, don't we, really?
It does change a lot as well, I think.
Yeah, and then like a lot of our early songs, like Flickers, Dan, basically you started writing that, didn't you, and had like I actually remember this so well. You had a slightly different version. He had all the guitar worked out, and he had "Every Time I Go to Bed."
But it was
very slightly different, isn't it?
It's funny because as we've come along as a band, obviously that synergy has changed a lot as well. I think this is part of growing as a band together. So.
Our album If You Wait in September, and it has changed things a lot.
At home it's been really successful, which has been good, and I think here it's been quite successful. I mean, this is our very first time in Australia, so I think it's going to be interesting to see how much of an impact the album has made here. It's always interesting, and whenever we go to a new country it's always completely different, but I think we're pretty blessed with how it's gone so far.
With the video for Strong, it was a guy called Sam Brown who, he's based in LA, and we kind of have like a general brief of things that we will do or won't do, things that we want, or the vibe kind of thing, but the whole concept was his own, and the guy blowing himself up with fireworks, he didn't blow himself up, but he had a suit that blew up.
I think the music does lend itself well to remixing and dance music in general. Mainly probably because of Hannah's vocal. I think like it sounds quite iconic, and I think that's what any dance producer is looking for. And I think that's a prime example of how the Disclosure song came about.
I think the fact that there's a lot of space in our music as well, it means it lends itself to interpretation, because, you know, dance music, obviously people are like, ooh, I can add so much to that and like make it not boring so people can dance to it. Whereas at our gigs, like obviously, you know, people don't dance. They think about life. Actually, that's not true. Sometimes they do dance.
More energy,
right?